Are you bored, Julie?
Oh, who isn't?
What about you, Stella? Are you bored?
Nothing ever happens at our school.
The typical analysis indicates that tonight's concert practice is the 1756th that I've attended. And not to be granted the most of the average Salvationist, I should attend another 6633 before death is followed up in victory.
Ashes to ashes, dust to dust.
It's time you vibrant, dynamic young Salvationists went home to bed.
Oh, don't you start, George. You know we're serious. We've had enough. This place is dead. Dead as the gas fire telephone.
It's only as dead as you are. Look at your fine examples of sparkling Salvationism you are. Now, why don't you stop moaning and do something for the Corps?
Do something for the Corps? Julie, you get the flowers. John, you see the undertaker. And I'll bury the thing for you.
Honestly, look, this place could be sizzling if only you lot put your minds to it. Can't you see that, John? Now look, if Brain's there, if he was less concerned about his precious British telephone chairs, all three of them, and if he was more concerned about the court, or if you, Stella, if you were more worried about the court than your looks, well, something could happen.
That's all very well, George, but it'll take an earthquake to make this place happen.
All this needs is a, injection of new life.
You mean a kind of blood transfusion?
A sort of emergency operation.
Well, I think it needs a kiss of life.
I'll tell you what it needs. It needs a takeover bid. A takeover bid by the young.
You're right, Brian. It's a takeover bid.
He's done it again.
We can do it too.
Thank you.
tomorrow, today.
Hey, that's great. Just what we want for a slogan. We'll build the army of tomorrow, today. That should shape the things, all right. I can just see us advancing on them now with our battle cry. We'll build the army of tomorrow, today. Come on, join in.
We'll build the army of tomorrow, today.
Yes, but what kind of army are we going to build? You need more than a slogan. Surely you need some kind of a program.
The boy's right. What we need is a manifesto. We need to tell the world about the new army. The army of tomorrow, that we emerge under our purposeful and dynamic leadership. We trust us, not them, us. We will build you the army of tomorrow, today. As you will see in our manifesto, our specific proposals are...
Oh, help me, stop! Quick, someone, fetch an idea.
Fetch a chair, anyway.
Is he all right? Back, everyone. He must have air.
Careful, our brains. We're all with you.
He must have passed the host of the army.
Quiet. Can you see what I can see? Smoke, it's coming.
Wait for it. Any minute now. Pearls of wisdom.
I think we should go back to having meetings every night of the week.
Oh, no. That's out.
In the old days, the corps officer used to head the march on a white horse.
Oh, don't be silly.
That's out.
Brave for general.
In!
I got it!
Did you hear that? He's got it. Wait for it.
If it's in, it's in. And if it's out, it's out.
Why, Brave, that's wonderful. Marvellous. What on earth does it mean?
Bring me a paper. We must pool our ideas. Everyone must feel free to say what he thinks, so we can decide once and for all what the army's image shall be. We'll write it down. Here, in our charter. If it's in the book, it's in. If it's not in, it's out. Now gather round. Close your eyes. Do you see the army of tomorrow just like you want it to be? Now tell me all about it. Let's have your ideas. I'm waiting.
Oh,
grown weary. It's the world that's grown weary. Tired and disillusioned men are seeking to build a new world. Grey men are trying to bring colour to the grey world. But for them there are no more hopes, no visions, no dreams. Too many of their dreams have been smashed on the hard rocks of reality. And they dream no longer. For I have a dream. I dream of a world where sorrow and pain should be no more. I dream of a world where there will be no want, no hunger, no strife. I dream of a world where little children will grow up to love, not to hate. Am I wrong to dream of this? Are the grey men right? Must we become hard and cynical too? Are we wrong to dream of a new world? Are we?
Must there be tears and discontent?
our plan to get out to the course as soon as possible.
Okay then, tomorrow night is D-Day. We'll all arrive here together and present our chart to the local officers. I hope the shock doesn't kill them. Stella, you get some banners made, and Brains, your job is to get the chart written out properly. 8 o'clock tomorrow night then, everybody.
Right, come on you lot, line up. You've heard of the French Revolution and the storming of the Bastille. That was mere dishwater compared with what's going to happen here tomorrow night.
Hey, what's this, the charge of the Light Brigade or something?
By the time we're through, the charge of the Light Brigade will seem like a pleasant country ramble. Now, forward troops, what is it we want?
Twenty years, in fact. I agree, Major.
Good.
We ought to do something. Something right.
Yes.
How about closing the youth club? They make such a noise during my corporate ed class. You never know, you have to prepare for that.
Yes.
You'll be remembered for that, Major, if you close the youth club.
Oh, yes. Do you remember? Do you remember Commandant Laurie Brown? Do you remember him?
Yes.
He closed the weeknight meeting.
Do you remember Adjutant Winterbottom?
Yes, I remember. She was a saint.
She closed the afternoon praise meeting.
Very, very good thing, too. Very good thing, too. Yes. And that ensign, Hittlewell. He stopped the Sunday morning knee drill.
And he became a commissioner. All the best officers are always remembered, Major.
Well, of course I had thought of closing the youth club. In view of the general's demand, don't you think that we ought to consider opening something for charge?
What did you have in mind, Major?
I thought we could have an open air campaign on the housing estate.
Impossible! They've only just moved in, you know. Give them a chance to settle down. You'll do more harm than good in the rushing now.
But I thought those houses were built before the war.
Oh, yes, Major. But they weren't occupied till after.
Well, if that's too extravagant, how about a life-saving guard troop?
Oh, no, Major.
Well, how about a joy hour?
Oh, no, Major.
More war cries to be sold?
No.
A club for the old?
No.
New juniors be won?
Impossible, no.
Let something be done.
Impossible, no.
But...
No.
people of today don't want to do nothing.
But this is what all this is about. We do want to do something.
You want to do something? Yeah, they want to do something. Good, good. Well, who's stopping us? Who's stopping us?
Well, they are.
Well, them?
Yes, them.
Oh, you stand in the way of these fine young people. Shame on you. Shame on you.
Well, what exactly did you have in mind?
Give you the chance. Let us take over the running of the court, say, for about 3 months. And in that time, we...
Did you say 3 months? We've had a letter from the general, you know. What did you say? A dynamic? Vibrant?
You're right, isn't it? Yeah.
Victorious? Resolute?
Enthusiastic?
Extraordinary outbreaks be made during the next 3 months. Just what the general ordered. The local officers can take a rest, a well-earned rest, if I may say. And you could return to resume your arduous duties. Do you agree, my comrades?
Well, of course I agree. Now I'm Angeline. Boys and girls, this is your alien, not ours, isn't it? But we'll help you all we can, won't we? Boys and girls, this is your hour.
Bye.
you've got your work cut out there. But your co-op hasn't had a takeover bid, has it? Look at that programme.
7:30 Monday mornings, go to work on a prayer,
all the way through the week to Sunday night, late night final, which follows the youth crunch, which follows the late night open air meeting, which follows the wind up, which follows the salvation meeting. I mean, need I go on? For a bit, I wouldn't have it any other way. You've got to admire these young folk, the way they've thrown themselves into this takeover business.
I know, they took them nothing else down to Blue Angel. It's Sally Army Beast and Sally Army Bat. Oh, hello, Apple.
Hello, Bloody.
Hello, Auntie Daddy.
It's your old man.
What, him? What do you take me for? What do you find a lady like me be doing the likes of him? Nah, he's in the same line of business as your uncle. He looks after this all for the Sally Army.
They do a grand work.
You can say that again, Ethel. Hey, George, do you remember me asking you about the missing persons department? Well, I found her. That fairy mother-in-law. She's been missing for years. Mind you, we're doing our best to lose her again. Now, what about Mr. Grabbing, Ethel? You know who that he is. Well, they'll fix him up with a brand new hearing aid.
They've been giving me a hand too, you know. Ever since my husband died, I haven't had a lot of time to look after the place. My discovery was in the shop mistake. But they've sent two or three men round from the army there. Fixed up lovely, haven't they?
Here, give me my ear. That's glad I tuned.
That's music to my ear.
Me throat's gone all dry, all sudden like.
You know what you could do with my dear?
A nice cup of tea.
I know, I take it. Harry Sugars.
Two for me.
Not for me, George. I'm slimming. Well, trying. Nice fella, George.
Yes, he seems a nice chap.
Yeah, a real Christian he is. And he's missed a lovely lady. A real top. They came to see me when I was in hospital. Appendicitis. I thought I was going to die. They did me the power of good. You want to look them up next time you get a fit of the dump? Say I suggested it. Oh, here he comes. Ain't he an angel?
Just what I need. Hi, George.
Bless you, George.
Ooh. Ah.
Yeah.
hot. Strong. Intoxicating. Home league. Psychedelic.
Thank you. neighbours with the flu.
Now we know that somebody cares about us.
You see, all
How are you doing, my dear? I'm down your street the other day, you know, saw that washing on the line. You know you'll catch your death of cold wearing those flimsies. Or to take a leaf out of your neighbour's book, you know, that woodhouse woman. Just especially of you.
He'll keep you warm, man.
Next door, but I've tried to do my best for him. I told you, didn't I, that crow that got in with would land in the trap.
club opens at 10:30 tonight, Chris. See you then.
We'll see you there.
Well, I shouldn't think so. It's only for the young.
What? No!
Well, we'll see. Come and join us, come and join us.
Something. Well, anyway, you're going to get this club ready. You've got a lot of work to do yet.
All right, George, it'll be done. It'll be done.
They do work hard.
We've got to hand it to you. This takeover business of yours is a brilliant idea. Building an army to be proud of. An army that really cares.
An army that cares about old people.
An army that cares about the children. An army with its sleeves rolled up.
A fighting army.
A serving army.
A singing army.
An army of compassion.
Thank you.
show you where's that.
Oh, charm, don't you?
Have a coffee, George?
Thank you.
Oh, thank you. Here, George.
Thank you.
Oh,
Yes, I really do believe this miracle business, as you call it. All that you need, it is available at the moment you turn to the Lord.
Do you believe it? Do you? And you? I could do with a miracle. I could just do with a miracle. Oh God, what a mess!
Trophy. for young folk to be independent, to think that they can manage.
So you think we should have been invited the old folk, would you, George?
Oh, I don't know about that. Think about Herbert and Archer with their bumpers. They were really good.
No, that's not what I meant. It's just that it's God's work you've been trying to do, but haven't you been trying to do it without him? And far be it from me to quote the good book at you, but except the Lord build the house.
They labour in vain to build it.
Precisely. Now isn't that exactly what we've all been trying to do these past few weeks? Now, I'm no philosopher, but experience has taught me a thing or two. Am I boring you?
No.
In every street, you'll find a home dark and despair, empty of hope and happiness and full of care. The streets are thronged with aching hearts, skies with cries unheeded. To heal the hurts of hearts like these, a miracle is needed.
We know a miracle. And how can it be done? We want to see a miracle, but how's it begun?
Oh, I've seen many miracles. If you had seen the grace of God come to a slut and make her clean, or take a drunkard by the neck and shake him free of sin, you wouldn't ask me how to make the miracles begin. Our early saints were nobodies. They were not worldly wise, no schooling to be spoken of, no wealth we'd recognise, no reputation and no friends, no ritual routine. They had God inside of them, and miracles were seen. But when the Church of God on earth relies on friends and wealth, she leans a great deal less on God and more upon herself. We have a glorious heritage. We're proud of what we've built. But when it comes to miracles, we bear our share of guilt. For whilst we boast of better bands and better brains as well, those folk that need a miracle go quietly to hell. Our opposition's vanished. Our supporters have increased, and everyone speaks well of us. But miracles will cease. God presses into service, the most unlikely man to do his work of miracles. He uses who he can. He longs to work his miracles. But looking round for tools, he searches in these churches and he finds a load of fools. What can he do with folk like you who think that you know best? Who think that miracles are worked through gimmickry and zest? He must despair!
But we must care about the sick, the sad. It must be right to do any good. Our service can't be bad.
Oh no. It's right to care about the old, the sad, to gather little children in and make them glad. But men have deeper needs as well. Needs hidden and unheeded. To cure the cankered soul of man, a miracle is needed. But God's the same. He hasn't changed. His promises are true. He longs to work his miracles through you and you and you.
I want through me. It's got to be at work in other men. I want to be his implement. His voice, his tool, his pen. But can it happen? When does God, through ordinary folk, change extraordinary things in miracles?
When men in desperation turn to God, then God comes in, abides in them, and by his power, the miracles begin. When any man approaches God, his coming is the same, no matter what his state of grace, his title, or his name. He comes with sorrow for his sins. He comes sometimes with tears. He brings his hidden longings. He bears his secret fears. He brings what he had seemed to owe and yields it all to Christ. His energy, his wit, his wealth, his all is sacrificed. Then God descends, except all he can set his seal upon, and minor miracles begin with this tremendous one. By God, and not by you, a takeover by him could make our wildest dreams come true. Our stupid independence is our universal sin. And who sees this has seen the place where miracles begin. They used to speak of holiness uttermost salvation, baptism by the Holy Ghost, and soul sanctification. Well, you can call it what you like. This is man's deepest need, for God to take control of him. A takeover indeed. Without that, nothing that we do, done with whatever skill, can work the wonder that we need. Yet it can happen still.
We want to come to God, and we want God to come to us. We recognize our need for just this supernatural plus. We want Him to take over, and we will do what He demands. We're just hoping for it.
It isn't hard to come to God if you're sincere. You can encounter God again, right now, and here. Apologising isn't hard when pardon is so sure, and power is found when it is sought, the motive being pure. God's still the same. He hasn't changed. His promises are true. He longs to work His miracles through you, and you, and you.
Wonders begin.
told us enough. But not everything, it seems.
Well, you know me, always down in the dumps. Well, the matter suggested I had a long talk with George and his missus about it. And to cut a long story short, it's happened. It's a blooming miracle.
I don't know about this sort of thing, but I'd never have thought it could happen to me. But it has. It's happened to me.
Wonders begin when the Lord comes in.
Wonders begin when the Lord